step.
First off, thank you so much for making me feel so special last week on Librarians Day. I really appreciate your kind words and thoughtfulness. I love this job, and I'm so glad I get to come to school and be with all of you every day. Thank you. Last week, a student was looking for this book, The Elements. We couldn't find it on the shelf, but it has returned. But I can't remember which student was wanting this book. So if that's you, I have it here waiting for you. Don't forget to take a look at our adventure book. I've updated it recently with lots of our newest reading adventures. We've had a lot of great adventures this year so far. This is just a book that's going to stay in the library, but you can look at it when your class comes to library. It's not something you can check out, but it has some great pictures and some great memories of what we've done so far this year. So be sure to look at it. If you are participating in our March Madness contest, the championship game is tonight. Don't forget to total up how many of your predictions you guessed correctly. Then turn your bracket in to me by this Wednesday. Make sure your name is on your paper as well as your teacher's name. If you need to update your bracket, you can do that during first recess or when your class comes to library. Or if it's okay with your teacher, you can come up before 9 a.m. first thing in the morning. Prizes will be announced on CBS News next week, so be sure and get your brackets in by this Wednesday. April is National Poetry Month. Don't forget our poetry challenge. Read a poetry book or write a poem. Then you get a prize and you get your name entered in a drawing to win a poetry book. If you write a poem, be sure to turn in a nice final copy that is in your best handwriting, or you can type it. Try to fit it on a half page or smaller. You can turn poems in before 9 a.m. or at first recess or when your class comes to the library. We've had some great poetry turned in already, so be sure to look over the poems on this bulletin board inside our library when you come. If you read a book of poems, just let me know which poem was your favorite when your class comes to library. And feel free to share your favorite poem with your class. You can read it to them, or you can memorize it and recite it to them. We also have some fun poetry up in the hallway outside of the library that students created during their class library time last week. So be sure to take a look at these. We had one more student who finished reading all of the Beehive nominees before that challenge ended. Congrats to Beckham. He is the only third grader that read all 40 of the Beehive nominees. Good job. Last but not least, we have a few brand new books for our library. Two picture books. This one, Jerome by Heart, about two boys that are best friends. And this one called Dad by My Side. If you love spending time with your dad, I think you'll really enjoy this book and relate to it. And then finally, I've ordered this for so long and it finally came in, the newest Hazardous Tales about Lafayette. This book, Bears on the Ice, is the second in the series. We got the first book with the grant books that we got, and so I ordered the second book. So if you have enjoyed that, you'll like the second one. And this one I told fifth and sixth grade about. This is perfect for fifth and sixth graders. The Truth is Told by Mason Buttle. It's a wonderful story. It won an honor award for the Schneider Family Book Award. So all of these are available this week to check out. Happy reading.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I like to move it.
You like to
move it.
I like to move it. I like to move it.
I like to move it.
You like to
move it.
Respect.